Now I am going for an example and I am going to show this example with two different methods. First of all, how to proceed the first principle, and secondly, when it is given, first principle is given to us, we are knowing about the first principle, then directly we can apply it or not. Okay. So this example will clear each and every doubt for you for the first principle. Now the question is, we have to differentiate y is equal to x square. Okay, now let this be 1. Now adding delta y, small increment of y, 2y, and delta x, small increment of x to x, we get y plus delta y is equal to x plus delta x whole square. Okay, now subtracting one from two, y plus delta y minus y is equal to x plus delta x whole square minus x square. Okay. So we are having delta y is equal to x plus delta x whole square minus x square. Now dividing both sides by delta x and taking limits, delta x approaches to 0. Now what we can write it? Limit delta x approaches to 0, delta y by delta x is equal to limit delta x approaches to 0, x plus delta x whole square minus x square upon delta x. Okay. Now what this becomes? If you remember what this becomes now, now this becomes dy by dx. Okay, you can go through the last module, you will be getting that this becomes dy by dx. Basic thing is you can go for the geometrical interpretation also. Now this is equal to limit delta x approaches to 0, x square plus 2x delta x plus delta x whole square minus x square upon delta x. Limit delta x approaches to 0, delta x common, and we are left with 2x plus delta x upon delta x. Now this cancels. Limit delta x approaches to 0, 2x plus delta x is equal to 2x. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to 2x. This is the answer. Now, this is the very systematic way what we have done it. Very systematized. Now, directly, we have gone through the definition 2. Now, let this is alternative. Alternative, now let fx is equal to x square. Now, here it is given y is equal to x square. We are writing let fx is equal to x square, where y is equal to fx. Is it clear? Now, by definition, f derivative x is equal to limit h approaches to 0 f x plus h minus fx upon h. Now fx, it is given as x square. It means, now be careful what we are writing here. This will become limit h approaches to 0 x plus h whole square minus x square upon h. Remember, it will become like this, because here it is x plus h function. X plus h, x is x square, so it means we are going to go whole square for this one. Now this becomes limit h approaches to 0 x square plus 2xh plus h square minus x square upon h. Same thing, same process, this one and this one. You can just see that these two steps are same. Is it clear? So finally this becomes limit h approaches to 0 h common 2x plus h upon h, limit h approaches to 0 2x plus h, and this is equal to 2x. Therefore f derivative x is equal to 2x. So this is the basic thing which you should be knowing, this part, okay, and you can directly go for this, that part also.